Welcome to Dan ARG YouTube. Emmanuel Agbogun, say land grabber like Curtis Ugbo must go to jail. He say na the Okaigele of Ologbo. Make I leave you, make you hear from Emmanuel.
Yes, good morning to you all, my conscious Edo people. If you are watching with me this morning, I would want to take just 20 minutes of your busy time to leave a message on social media. There have been a lot of issues, you know, relating to land grabbing, part of which I'm in Abuja for. And during the election and after the elections, what we all supported was wanting to provide a better and enabling environment for our people in Edo to actually get a better society. There have been a lot of issues ranging from land grabbing, no street lights in Edo, issue of insecurity, issue of bad roads. And everybody who is on social media knows that since 2006, I have been on the media agitating for a better society. And not only that, I have always tried to use my platform to contribute my own quota, my own belief and my views to the society. I've been seeing issues of in-house fighting and, you know, comrades exchanging themselves, political associates, you know, throwing tantrums among themselves, dragging and fighting for the media space. I have not been involved. I only just go there to comment. But basically, an issue came up 3 days ago. They drew it to my attention. I ordinarily did not want to participate in it. But after careful analysis of the situation, I decided to come out full, you know, full scale. Firstly, I'm letting people know that if anything should happen to me, whether I'm in Benin City or I'm not in Benin City, Curtis Egosu Aigbo and the Secretary of the Benin Traditional Council should be held responsible. And Ebo Amaba. And a lot of others, I'll be mentioning their name as soon as I arrive Benin. See, the truth be said, nobody is holy. But we should not allow criminals to continue taking charge of our society as if we don't have laws that operate. Before I start on the issue of Curtis and land grabbing in Olobo, I want to first of all let Edo people know that this is a fight we all must come together, irrespective of our political divide. We must all come together to ensure that there's sanity in the system, because what we all owe ourselves is sanity in the system. Whether you like my face or you don't like my face, or you like my voice or you don't like my voice, what we all want is that there should be sanity in our system. Firstly, I'm not in Benin, I'm in Abuja, and I came to Abuja because the police from Abuja came into Benin to arrest some youths and took them down to Abuja here. Yesterday, we were able to secure their bail, but however, it is not my right to mention the community. And it is also not my right to throw the issue on the media, because I have not sought the permission of the host community that, you know, was affected. Having said that, I just want to let the whole world know that the majority reason why there's land grabbing in those states is because of this Abuja police arrest. Once there's an issue in a community where they ought to go for civil settlement in the court, they will all resort to coming to Abuja to write one petition to either the IG or the DIG or the IRUT police unit. That is the growing trend in Edo states. In fact, the Abuja police are the major factor why we have land grabbing in Edo states. Nearly all the communities, the moment there is an issue, one party will run down to Abuja to write petition to use police to arrest whoever they want to arrest. And even if the police in Benin has arrested the situation, they know how to run down to Abuja to write petition to bring the case file down to Abuja so that the case will die a natural death and be in their favor. This is a growing trend that the Edo State government must also check. This is a growing trend that the Edo State government must also check. Now, having said this, I want to go down to the issue of Olobo. You all know, in the issue of Olobo, it had to deal with Johnson and Sonny Eche and the Enoge and Curtis Ugbo. At some point, Kosibo was saying that he was protecting the interest of the Benins, and that what he was doing in Olugbo was to ensure that the Shekiris are not seen to be taking Benin lands. When I came out to see that Edo people should look in depth, that they are not only going after fighting for the Benins, they are also collecting the source of livelihood from the Benins. I mentioned a woman in MPDC that owned the contract with MPDC for the over 30 years securing MPDC platform, and how Kotisugwa and the Enogi of Olugbo went to MPDC to seize that job from the woman. She's still alive today. Her security outfit is still in Benin, and she can also speak for herself. After that, Curtis narrowed it down that I'm not a Benin boy, I'm from Agbo, I'm married to Ashelege's daughter, mentioned all sorts of things, and even arrested me in the process. He arrested me with the homicide department, alleging me of terrorism, alleging me of defamation of character, alleging me with all sorts of allegations, courtism, all sorts of allegations. In all the process when he alleged me to the police, he was invited severally. Even when I was granted bail on the same day of my arrest, he protested to the AIG that he caught a criminal and they allowed the criminal go. Till date, they have invited him for a series of interviews with the AIG. He has refused to show up. In that same time, Kotisubo hired some people, some two youths who were caught with illegal firearms, some of who are escapees from the prison today. Kotisubo hired them to go and acquire arms and serve him as a bodyguard. That was in the public glare. Nobody said anything about it. Everybody was quiet. Today, they have used the influence they have to sweep that under the rug. But we are still watching, because I am very happy that when all of these things get matured, we'll be brought before a legal panel of public investigation to ask questions and investigate. And if I'm found wanting, they should prosecute me when necessary. And if Kotisubo is also found wanting, they should prosecute him. Now, do you know in Olugbo, what made me to meet Johnson was an issue of a land belonging to the Ekato family. Land that the Ekato family developed since the 1970s as their source of livelihood. They were into Banga farm, Banga plantation as the case may be, and they had a very, very large expanse of land measuring over 12 hectares of land in Olugbo that they acquired from various indigenous people of Olugbo community at a certain time. I was not called to Olugbo by even the Ekato family. I was called into the issue by Edo professionals in diaspora, you know, emanating from the Olugbo community as indigenes, majority of whom were Benins, and we're not too happy with the Ashelege approach to the administration of community affairs in Olugbo. I waved in, and we tried to resolve that with Chief Johnson before the issue of Sonichi and Kotisubo arose. I made very many efforts to reach Kotisubo, even on phone, to tell him that these are my findings. What is your findings? Let us know how to match issue and resolve the crisis in Olugbo. Curtis declined. At some point, he told me that, the issue has gone beyond what my capacity can handle, and he was going to do what is necessary to ensure that he puts Chief Johnson where he belongs. And on that basis, I started finding that they were even going out of what they were fighting for, hijacking people's contracts, seizing people over people's land, himself and the Enogi. And I quickly drew public attention, but because at that time people felt that, oh, who is Emmanuel Agbogun? He's an enemy of Edo people, and very many of Edo people were on the sentiment of the Tugba and Obaseki second tenure. Nobody gave me the listening ear that issue ought to have, you know, deserved. Now, the same Ekato land, the same Ekato family land, Kotisubo is not telling them that they don't own the land there, that in the entire stretch of their family Banga plantation, that what they will get is 3 plots. You will hear from the horse's mouth in no distant time. It is just because I'm not in Benin. But the truth be said, I have noticed something with Curtis. If, in case of Edo people don't know, I, who is seated here, Emmanuel Agbogun, I made Curtis the BOT chairman of Edo Youth Congress. After the first Edo Youth Summit, the prayers we got from the palace, from our Reverend Oba, or by Rediawa of Blessed Memory, I think the clips are still very much available with the palace. I was invited by the palace in 2012, and all that abide at that time was that Edo youths come together to ensure that we have a sustainable template where we can air our grievances to government. And we had a successful summit that had the presence of the former commissioner for education, the former SSA to governor of youth affairs, the former commissioner for youth and sports, and other, I think the speaker at the House of Assembly then, Right Honorable Igbe, was also an active participant in that summit. And so after that summit, the cow, the palace gave to us, the drinks and food the palace supported us with, and Oba Kenzua Cultural Center, all the proceeds, we then stood and held a three-day summit and made Kotisubo the beauty chairman of Edo Youth Congress. Believing that Kotisubo was running an NGO called Face to Face Initiative that was, you know, powered by Edo Diasporans, and he had a, you know, reaching capacity of supporting what the media needs of our advocacy at that time was, particularly paying for the cost of ITV and ABS and other media outfits. But what later transpired was that Kotisubo was using us to bargain with the Edo State government on our struggle for property tax that is now being implemented today in Edo State, where he has not made a single statement about. He hijacked the protest, sold us out for 5 million naira to the former government, and got an appointment as an SSA. So that's why when some people talk about Kotisubo, I say he's somebody I know very well. He's somebody that I felt was responsible. And in the long run, people like the likes of, what's this former PDP spokesman to Atiku Abubakar from Edo North. I don't know if somebody can help me with his name. Kasim Afuebua and Klemaba, we were almost sharing the same office of Binoni by what's it popularly called, I don't really remember that name of the road in GR, where Curtis had an office, you know, where he told us all sort of lies. And at the end of the day, he even drove youths who were activists, he drove all of us out of his office at gunpoint. And people, comrades are there who can attest to what I'm saying. It's not hidden. He hijacked money from NDDC that was given to us as a subvention to pilot the affairs of Edo Youth Congress. Edo Youth Congress is a general body registered with the Edo State Ministry of Youth and Sports to pilot the affairs of Edo Youth. When we saw that Kotisubo was, you know, not willing to allow that body stand, we now formed the coalition of Edo Youth Organization, which is still existing to today, headed and piloted by the person of Comrade Culture. You know, certificates that were registered by government for us is still in place and can be found with Comrade Culture to portray my point where the need be. In all of this, when we saw that civil society was not becoming what we wanted in Edo State, some of us as comrades decided to go our various way and advocate to the best of our ability. That is where we have all found ourselves today in Edo State. Now, what is painful to me is that I am very happy that Afolabi is alive. I am very happy that Kotisubo is alive. I am very happy that those people he hired to protest against me, they are all alive. What is funny today is that Kotisubo alleged me to be a terrorist. Kotisubo alleged me to be all of these points, sorry, excuse me, that are all false. Till today, there is still an open investigation with the Homicide Department and the ZIB where he wrote those petitions to. He has refused to answer one single invitation where the AIG has invited both parties to come before them. He has ensured that he never came for any of the interviews. And to date, I told the police that I will not waste my resources to protest, because I know even while I protest, the police will still not want to do the needful, because Kotisubo is hiding under the influence of the palace. And that is why some of us have always come out in the open to say that Frankie Rabaul and some other elements around them are the ones aiding Kotisubo. Now, what is Kotisubo resorting to now in Edo State? In a Lobo community, Kotisubo is not the Okaigele. He's not the one selling land with the Enoge. In fact, nearly all the lands on the express coming from the bridge in Olobo to the boundary with Obanyato, Kotisubo is there. In fact, they are busy selling it. People's land owned by people from Olobo. And majority of these people are not in Nigeria. Majority of the indigenous of Olobo, particularly the first sons of majority of the families that are deceased, they are majorly professionals. If you must know, Olobo houses the most educated Edo people across Benin, Edo's South Senatorial District, Olobo community, professionals in various endeavor. I can go on and on if you want me to mention their name. One of the biggest, or in fact, plants of Toyota is being managed by an Olobo son in West Africa. It's been, I don't want to mention his name because I've not sought his permission. It's been managed by that Olobo son. I know him very well. Their body as an association in the diaspora, I know them very well. You know, at that point when I was saying that people should not read Johnson to be the way it is. So many people, you know, read very many meaning. But today, thank God, to an extent, I have been vindicated. Kotisubo is now after people's family land. Very many of the people from Olobo, they are not back home because of their engagements abroad. They are professionals. Most of them are lawyers. Yes, very many of them are professionals. When I mean very many of them who I am in touch with are professionals. And they are letting me know that it's because of their engagements and this COVID-19. That's why they have not been able to come back home. Now, as I speak to you, they are busy selling land. And I asked, is the duty of an Enugu and Enugu, is it to sell land? If Kotisubo says it's genuine, he supported Obaseki government. He said that they should stand and say no to God for that reason. Obaseki government has, you know, been able to assess a loan for oil palm revolution in Edo State. He has been able to assess a loan for oil palm revolution in Edo State. How come Kotisubo and his like that are close to the palace, that are even now seen as a vice chairman recovery committee of Oba's property in Edo State in Benin Kingdom? How come they are not using or tapping from the resources to create jobs for Edo people in Olobo, despite the expanse of land? How come they are now interested in selling these lands to strangers when they say they are Benin people? How come they are not annexing the land to continuously create employment for Benin people that are unemployed? Even where we are in a state that have assessed over 70 billion naira as support grants to interested farmers who want to come and explore the rich oil palm opportunity we have in Edo State. How come they are not using the might of the palace and the mind of their capacity as community leaders in Olobo to harness this opportunity to create agro-allied employment for our people? No, it is because their intention is to enrich themselves. Kotisubo, asking where he works, asking what he does, asking what business he owns, he does not have. Majority of his mates who graduated from Uniport, when he was in Uniport, they are all professionals. I know very many of them in Slumberger. I know very many of them in ExxonMobil. I know very many of them, you know, in various parastatals, government parastatals like Sun and NAFDAC and other government parastatals, like even NOA. I know one of Kotisubo's classmates who is in NOA. I am a Port Harcourt boy. When I mean I'm a Port Harcourt boy, I was born in Port Harcourt. I schooled in Port Harcourt. I grew in Port Harcourt. I know the streets of Port Harcourt very well. You know, I lived in Port Harcourt for over 20 years of my life before proceeding to the University of Abuja. Now, I am asking a very simple question. What right does Kotisubo have to administrate over land in Olobo community? What empowers him to become an Okaigele, to now start telling families who have been living in Olobo since the 70s, before Ugbo was born, who were born there, have their ancestral land that they inherited from their fathers and grandfathers and their parents bought to also establish a business that their children can fall back to at a time like this? How come Kotisubo is the one measuring what size of land they should own in Olobo? The issue is very simple. Kotisubo at some point realized that he doesn't have anything to fall back to in life. The only thing he has to fall back to is to be chanting praises for the palace. And while he will be chanting praises for the palace, he will use that to gain more influence, to see how he can economically, you know, exploit the people of Olobo. Do not forget, Olobo was existing in 2007 when Kotisubo was an SSA to government. When Kotisubo was an SSA to the governor, when he meets Oshomole one-on-one, he did not harness any opportunity to better the life of Olobo people. Now, because Olobo, Obaseki has been able to create one or two platforms where investors would look at it as an economic hub. There's gas in Olobo. There are other viable natural resources in Olobo. Kotsubo is not talking on how to harness that to create employment. What Kotsubo is after is to sell land. Very few hours from now, I will be interviewing the families of the Ekatos so that you will hear from the horse's mouth. This is the same Ugbo. I have alleged him now. He's not coming out to defend himself. Rather, he has higher social media aides that are under the payroll of his BSM, headed by the secretary of the Benin Traditional Council, to begin to ask me where is my certificate. And I asked Ugbo, am I an illiterate? It's not the first time I have brought up my certificate on the media to show the world. And if you are in doubt that I am not a graduate, how does that affect the fact that I am coming out to say that Edo people should know who and who is grabbing their land? Because you all saw me in the case of Egbiri and the Okoromi, and in the case of Ogede, when Ami went to destroy their land, I only went there to put the news on the public domain, just like what is going on in Okoroma. I am not interested in who wants to administrate land. My interest there is to ensure that there is sanity, to draw the attention of those people that will make sure that sanity comes there. So for those people who are fighting me, since yesterday I've been receiving all sorts of private calls threatening me that if I get into Benin, that they don't have in Abuja, if I get into Benin, they will deal with me, that they are going to ensure that they do XYZ. The question I want to ask, are you people above the law? Are you people above the law that somebody cannot speak? Once your names have been mentioned, you begin to feel that you can use the might to deal with anybody that you want to deal with. And I laugh at some of you. And in case of people are not aware, some of you will end up saying that, Imanala Igbogun is this, Imanala Igbogun is that. My grandfather, warrant officer, Igbogun, is the first man to join the British Army from Isi. The likes of late Paibomodia can attest, even if he is not alive today to speak for himself, his children, who knows my family well, are also alive. Now, having said this, I want to ask Edo people a question. Must it be that criminals must always be the one piloting affairs in our communities? How come we don't allow educated people? People that have what it takes intellectually. You see a community where you have lawyers, where you have doctors, an illiterate, a courtist will be the one that will be seen as an okaigele. An illiterate, a courtist will be the one that will be seen as an okaigele. How come in a community in Benin Kingdom, where we have learned people, each time they want to associate matters that affect us as a people, it's mostly illiterates you see championing it. Mostly illiterates. And at the end of the day, what they know all understand is, well, Vigore, bring the money here, let us spend. I can't keep myself. Those are the kind of swaggers that we see in our public space. You can imagine the issue of Okoma. Ebo Amaba started fighting with Ugbo. He fought with Ugbo. All surrounding communities, in Amaba, there's no one that they did not acquire their land. Now, they are not dragging across the river. Even if the river that they are claiming that is an Okoma, that is an Ago, and therefore it's a camp. The question I'm asking, must they be selling those land? Can't we use the land to harness better things that can help Edo people? Better things that can create employment? Go to the east. The Igbos will not cede their land to a stranger. They will ensure that wherever they work in all parts of the world, they come back home and erect structures that will develop their place. How come our own is different? Any small thing they want to sell one by one, they want to sell 1,000 by 1,000. The other day, I was in Obagenebusa, and the neighboring community to the same Okoma and Amamba. And a nigga sold 1 mile by 1 mile. 1 mile by 1 mile. In that nigga's community, there is no hospital, there is no functional classroom, this thing, there's even no street light. What's it called? Our distinguished senator, Matthew Ray, they brought borehole to the community, solar power borehole. What did the nigga did? He fenced the borehole inside his compound, restricting others from having access to the water in a community where people are looking for borehole to survive, pipe-borne water to survive. What are we living into in Benin Kingdom? The Benin Empire used to be a place where people would come and seek refuge, where people would come in and have comfort in the entire West African region. as the case may be. What are we having today? A slum. A slum. You see a full community develop without town planning. You see a full community develop without recreational centers, without creating spaces for future development that will come. Is that what we want as a people? When some of us talk, they tag us enemy of the palace. I've never seen when the palace will inherit my enemy and say they want to stand and fight my enemy. I've never seen a time when the palace will come out and say, oh, this thing that is affecting the Edo people, they don't want it anymore. It is only when we are coming out to say the truth that they will call us names. How long shall we begin to suffer in this mediocrity? How long, my people, I'm asking? How long? Now, Kotisupo is now seen as the chairman of Oba Recovery, Land Recovery Committee. What expertise has Kotisupo have? We have people who are subvious. We have people who are lawyers, who understand what legal framework and land administration is all about. How come they are not being hired to handle such office? How come it is criminals? Why? How do we lose this chain? That people no longer value certificate anymore. They want to value people that are of criminal tendencies. Kotisupo has been caught with illegal firearms. The case, you know, because they romance around our institutions, they know a way of how to go to ensure that they sweep the matter under the carpet. Ask a question like me. What rights does Kotisupo have to administrate lands in Olobo? What rights? So my conscience, Edo people, I can go on and on, but I just want to stimulate the media presence to the tune that this criminal should be investigated. Anybody that believe that I have sold one land, hear me very well, oh. Anybody that knows that I have sold one land in Benin, one land to him or her, that my name, I sold land to you in Benin Kingdom, should come out and testify. And if I am found wanting, I should go to jail. If I have sold one land, my grandfather have acres of land in Isi. We don't sell land. We are looking for investments, you know, to see how we can harness what our parents have acquired. But I cannot be a party to those people that will come and sell land. Even if you want to do that in my community, I will resist you. We can do better things with our land, not only selling and waiting for monies. These monies, after all, as far as I'm concerned, I used to buy second-handed vehicles that the Oibo, the colonial master that we have, has already written off to be a vehicle that should not be on the road. So how come this is what we are engaging ourselves in the 21st century, where technology is ruling the world, where innovations, ideas, are ruling the world? Can they be innovative with the land? Must they sell it? Ebu Amaba has sold almost all the land in Amaba community. Ebu Amaba is owning filling station. How many Amaba people can boast that they own filling station? How many Amaba people? Any group of people? Just like today, the Mega Comrade called me. Just like what Mega Comrade called me today to say about the issue of Apostle Yunusa. I don't think this issue of land grabbing is a personal matter. I have alleged Joel Okoromi. I'm saying it this morning now. Let the media hear. What are we saying about the Egbiri people that have sold lands to people that land that they are, even the palace have confirmed does not belong to them and the court? Why is nobody mentioning the Egbiri name? This is a very salient area we all must look into. Because when I come into Benin, I'm going to be ensuring that we create the needed consciousness that government should not tell us that we need to wait forever. As I speak to you now, even the military are willing to land grabbing. Even the military is into land grabbing. Everybody wants to take over land to see how they can use it to explore their own economic benefit to the detriment of other people who have expended their money. So this is my simple take. If you allow me, I will go on and on this morning. But because I have very many things to do this morning while I'm in the capital city, I will not want to stay behind the camera and say all these things that our people need to hear. But the truth be said, I am not interested in anybody giving me land or anything. All I want is just a better society. And Kotisupo, let me tell you, that Ekato land, leave that land alone. Because it is because of that land that you started calling me all sorts of names. Leave that land alone. You have alleged that you used to sponsor me. I don't know if, since you have known me, if you have given me 1,000 naira before. I cannot believe it. Daneche is still alive. Kola Edokpaye is still alive. Omo Efe is still alive. All the youths that partook in the Edo Youth Congress, they are all alive. They can verify. If you are supporting an organization, does not mean you are supporting me as an individual. So this is my simple take this morning. My people have raised a whole lot of issue, and I want us to begin to think. Edo in diasporas, Edo in diaspora, you people are the major investors in our economy. If people cannot galvanize to create an enabling environment, because you people brought the government of the day, if people cannot galvanize to create an enabling environment, it only amounts to the fact that you people are filling the space. Although most of you are doing your best, but if you people, particularly the professionals amongst you, if people cannot engage the system, because the government of the day has never thought it twice to hold a town hall meeting with us here in Nigeria. It is only those of you in diaspora that they run to, particularly when they need support for election and when they need votes. So we are looking and beckoning on all of you. That's why we come to the media to cry, because we know most of you have more access to the government than even we that are on ground here in Nigeria. So once again, I'll be joining you live as soon as I arrive Benin later tomorrow. I'll be joining you live. Kotisubo, I'm telling you this, I know you very well. Leave the Ekato family land, yourself and the Enugu of Olobo. Stop taking people's inheritance. Stop taking people's inheritance because you want to inherit yourself and your family. Stop taking people's inheritance. Olobo, have people that are well read, they can manage their affairs. Stop selling over their lands. Stop, desist from that, Ugbo. Stop selling over their land. That is my message to you. If you like, go and write on that petition. If you like, go and hire boys. I'm already aware that there are a mirage of boys that are now, you know, mobilizing to come and attack my person. I'm in Benin. Remember, anybody that is coming to attack somebody should be aware. Say, you know, leave your head for us. Now, your head didn't come. So anything will happen, you go easy here to carry on. That's what I'm telling you, because enough is enough for all this rascality. Today, very many of you are mobilizing cultists to join VGM because you want to use them to perpetrate illegality. The matter I came for in Benin, in Abuja here, how can vigilante arrest and open somebody who has fought a legal battle up to Supreme Court, arrest them and claim that they are taking over their land? When they have gone to court, court has given their judgment. The state government has also come from the Ministry of Lands and Survey to delineate a boundary. If not lawlessness, people from the palace will still be supporting such miscreants. These are our simple take. Until when we decide to allow the law to lead in our society, we will all continue to suffer this mirage of lawlessness. We will continue to suffer this mirage of intimidation and oppression. Because if that land in Olobo belongs to a Gbeledeon family, Kotsubo will not venture to enter inside that land. If that land belongs to the Oroide family, Kotsubo will not venture to enter into that land. If that land belongs to the Yama family or the Yamu family, I can go on, or the Adun family, Ugbo will not venture into that land. Why are they oppressing poor Benins? Why are they oppressing our Aboriginal Benin people that are poor? Why? This is a question that we are asking. Why? Must we sell our Benin land? If the people that were alive during the time of Oba Ozoluwa and Co. were selling land, which land will we really have to be selling now? Are we not thinking which land will we have to be selling? Agriculture is virtually dying despite the fact that we have borrowed 70 billion naira from the Central Bank of Nigeria. What are we benefiting for Nigeria that is exploring our oil? And now that they are giving us a fat, you know, support grant of 70 billion, how are we nursing it? How are we harnessing it? So this is my simple take this morning. We will continue to do what we feel is our own common contribution. Whether you like me or not, take my message and assimilate it and leave the rest for your own and that of the government to do. I rest my case for now. I am not that person. I'm your snowboard activist, comrade Aigbogun Emmanuel. Bye for now. But before leaving, if you know you have not shared this broadcast, please share. Send it to Ugbo's Kotsubo's messenger. Send it to him. I know you'll be watching one of his Prozzy accounts because he has very many. So send it to him. Yeah, their Prozzy account has been ringing my wall, asking me of my qualification. Ask a simple question: what has qualification got to do with land grabbing in Edo State? What has qualification got to do with expressing our views over the ugly trend of land grabbing in Edo State? I'm a victim, but though who tries me knows that they cannot succeed. So for the fact that they cannot oppress me, that does not mean I will not come out to speak about for those persons who their lands have been expressed. As I speak to you, I have over 300 cases. 300 cases. At times I get tired of picking most calls. 300 cases of land grabbing. What for people who spend millions of naira, some buy land 1.2 million, 1.3 million. These monies are in the pockets of criminals who don't want to work. who don't want to do anything meaningful to get a better life rather than selling over community land. And when they sell this community land, they fail to invest this money rightly to give them a better life. Whatever they are involved in is I can't keep myself. Sleeping from one hotel to another, from one beer parlor to another, I can't keep myself. And when the lands are no more, they adopt the Ebo Amaba pattern of ensuring that a community does not exist. I asked a question before leaving today's broadcast. Ebo Amaba, why were you wanting to become the Yonhe of Okoromi? Now, Okoromi is not a community, but you wanted to be the Yonhe of Okoromi. Why? 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 Bye for now. And Comrade Agbogu Emmanuel. More updates will meet your way very soon.
Now we don't hear from Emmanuel Agbogun, let us know what you think for this matter. Go to comment section, make you put your own for there. If you never subscribe to Dan ARG YouTube, try make you subscribe so that make you for the hear all the things where they happen for Edo State. Make I leave you now with this video, make you help us share them. Thank you for watching Dan ARG YouTube.